Welcome to the virtual classroom. Here we are going to see a machine learning project based on support vector machine to do the classification task. The task considered here is to recognize the handwritten digits using this support vector machine classifier. The demonstration is seen using Jupyter Notebook platform. So this slide explains the various steps involved in order to successfully complete this project. Not only for this project, for any machine learning project, these are the five important steps to be done. The very first step is to get the data set. So the step one represents import the required library functions and import the data set. So here we have considered the task to recognize handwritten digit. The famous MNIST data set has been used here. And step two is to pre-process the data. The data imported initially will be raw in approach. So in order to work with the machine learning model, we have to pre-process the data set first. In what way? So we can divide our data set, separating our input features and the output labels in order to use it for supervised classification tasks or regression tasks. And similarly, in order to train and test the machine learning model, we can split up our data set into two parts, like training set and testing set. And step three is to build the machine learning classifier model based on the suitable algorithm. Here we have chosen support vector machine because it is one of the good classifying algorithm. And here we are going to model SVM classifier and do the training process. Followed by step four is to do the testing process or do some predictions. And step five is to evaluate the performance of the model. If we are not happy with the model's performance, then we can improve the performance just by doing any of the tuning of hyperparameters that we will see in detail later. This is the problem statement. So what is the problem we have considered here? So we have considered handwritten recognition as our task. So the handwritten digits are having the various digits starting from 0 to 9. So the number of classes considered here is 10. So this classification task is basically a multi-class classification. What is the objective? So we are supposed to classify the handwritten digits. The goal is to identify or determine the digit depending upon the input image what we have fed to our machine learning model. Coming to the point of selecting the data set, we are going to use this famous MNIST data set. Basically, this MNIST data set comprises of 70,000 handwritten images. What is the challenge with respect to this particular project? If we see SVM, support vector machine classifier, may not work well with a huge data set. So considering the fact like 70,000 images actually a huge data set. So what is the solution for this particular challenge? There are two solutions. First solution is to reduce the size of the data set and work with our existing SVM algorithm. Or otherwise, we can make use of the 70,000 algorithm. By changing the algorithm to improve the performance of the algorithm, what we can do, we can hybridize our algorithm, that is support vector machine algorithm, with nearest neighborhood technique in order to improve its performance to make it suitable to work in a large data set. So these are our two solutions. So here in this demonstration, we are going to take into the fact of considering solution one. So this is the platform. So in your computer, you might be installing this Anaconda platform. Anaconda platform is useful to make use of all other working platforms like Jupyter Notebook, Scikit-learn, NumPy, Matplotlib, Pandas. So these are some of the machine learning library functions, and some of other programming functions are like PyTorch, TensorFlow, and many other things are available with Anaconda. So first step is to import our data set by including the required library function. So let me tell you what is library function. Library function is nothing but a collection of modules. So if we want to do some sort of important works, just by calling this library function, we can reduce by writing our own code in order to do this tedious task. So these are the following library function. Let me start with NumPy. NumPy is one of the library function which is used to handle the data set and do some sort of calculations also in our data set. And Pandas. Pandas is also a powerful library which is used to handle the data frame and analyze the data frame, like size of the data frame and splitting the data frame or data set into some parts, something like that. And matplotlib is an important visualization based library function, which is used to plot our data set in terms of graphs, required type of graphs. Scikit-learn is most important library function, using which only we can import any type of machine learning model we want. We can build, we can do testing and training process, and we can check the performance of our models, machine learning models. And not only that, this scikit-learn library function may have some sort of inbuilt data set. We don't want to go and search for data sets. Some of the useful and most sophisticated data sets are available inside the scikit-learn library function. Once we have our data set, we have to do pre-processing, right? Like if our data set is there, it would be available in one single matrix. We have to split up the data set into dependent variable and independent variable, where this independent variable represents the input features and this dependent variable represents the output target variable. So these two are the important things needed if suppose we are going to do a supervised machine learning algorithm or process. So coming to the type of the data set, so for handwriting digits or images, MNIST database is considered. This data set basically comprises of 70,000 images, and each image having a size of 28 number of rows and 28 number of columns. So 28 into 28 gives 784 pixels, calling it as these many number of features into account. So as I told before, we are going to solve our problem or overcome our challenge by using solution 1. So our solution 1 is to reduce the number of images in our MNIST database and to reduce the size of the image as well. So instead of handling our data from the size of 28 by 28, we are going to reduce the size to 8 by 8, where our image which we are going to handle right now is going to have 8 number of rows and 8 number of columns. So totally 8 into 8, 64 pixels are there, and these 64 pixels are considered as input features in order to train our model. So these are the handwritten digits available in MNIST dataset. So once we need to evaluate our model, so we can make use of certain performance parameters like precision, recall, F1 score, accuracy, and so on. So these are the details for implementing our machine learning algorithm. So now let us continue.